you look out on a sunny day across Puget Sound and you see the glistening blue water across the Olympics, it's hard to tell there's a problem.
So about 20 years ago, we noticed that salmon were not doing okay. Coho salmon in particular, when they would come back to spawn, were dying before they got a chance to spawn. And we learned that this was because of stormwater runoff that was getting into the creeks where they were trying to do their thing.
Stormwater is a complex cocktail of many thousands of chemicals. It's polluted runoff running down our roads and into our storm drains, and into our rivers and streams, and then to Puget Sound.
We were able to isolate it to something specifically about roadway runoff. And what we discovered is that it's not even directly a tire ingredient that's killing these coho. It's a chemical that's added to tires to protect them from ozone. 6 PPD is the name of that chemical.
All this stuff washing into our streams and rivers in Puget Sound every day. These atmospheric rivers are pushing all this stuff into the rivers and into Puget Sound.
And since we have impervious surfaces covering much of Puget Sound, the rain no longer infiltrates directly into the soil the way it would in a natural forest or wetland ecosystem, and Puget Sound is urbanizing more and more.
We know we have to replace that chemical in tires. But in the meantime, we have tools like green infrastructure.
When you look across our region, the main source of stormwater pollution is really these transportation corridors. So this project really started with one person, Mark Gray, who saw a video about salmon dying from stormwater pollution. And he is a private landowner, but he really needed to work with public agencies to get this work done because the stormwater that is flowing into these rain gardens is technically public stormwater. And so Mark initiated the project, and phase one is up the hill behind us. Phase two is right across the street. And now we're sitting in phase three, which is the largest. And in total, they capture about 2 million gallons of stormwater.
I think this project is actually a symbolic representation of sort of an authentic a community-based partnership between government, between neighborhood businesses in this area, just everyone who has stepped up to recognize that our tribal leaders, that our communities, and so many nonprofits and philanthropies and people have just really invested in what it takes to save the salmon.
If you can imagine your churches being closed, to that extent and not being allowed to worship where you want to worship and practice your traditional practices. That's the connection the tribes have to salmon. It's such a fundamental part of them. It's like breathing air.
I see small changes in our environment, like these rain gardens, and I get very hopeful for the future.
We need projects like this at scale. The I-5 Ship Canal Bridge Stormwater Treatment Project, if it happens, would treat almost 1 billion gallons of stormwater every year. That's incredible.
With 6 PPD, it's killing coho salmon, and it's something we need to deal with quickly. This is akin to our DDT of our generation. We knew it was killing bald eagles, it was killing rappers, we had to do something quickly. There was resistance by the industry, but eventually the nation rose up and said enough is enough. This is our DDT moment. Do we have the courage as a society to step up and say we need to do something now?
This project that we're sitting in right now is not something that was mandated by the state. It really organically grew from people recognizing the problem that existed and realizing they could be part of a solution.
We can restore our salmon population. We can do it. We have the tools, the knowledge, the skills, the entrepreneurial energy. You can just physically see how nature is cleaning up this sludge that comes from Highway 99, Aurora, goes down through the drain pipes and makes its way through a natural cleansing process to make it all the way to the water. And it's just, it's inspiring. It is nature at work.